marriage is not a do and die affair. Please look for help when you have problems in your marriage. You know, after a certain age, there is always this pressure from family and friends to settle down, especially in third world countries, in order to be recognized and be properly accepted or to be integrated into the society after a certain age, regardless of your mental, physical, or psychological condition. You must be married and be recognized as a wife or a husband to someone. For women, they are being reminded of their biological clock. As for men, they are always competent, even with 100 years. Marriage is a legally recognized union of two people as partners in a personal relationship. The definition of marriage varies from one country to the other, from one culture to the other, from one religion to the other. No matter your religion, country, culture, and continent, marriage is an institution in which interpersonal relationship, usually sexual, is acknowledged. Marriage, in other words, can be referred to as a universal culture. A lot of men and women are entrapped by morale and values of their societies. They are not happy and cannot do anything to solve their problems. Those who try to oppress oppression in marriage are termed feminists by women, by wives, by daughter-in-laws. These women face hostility, insecurities, lack of love and support from friends and families who were supposed to show them. Domestic violence is now on the increase, and the fact still remains that many women endure physical, emotional, or psychological, even financial abuse in silence. They refuse to speak up about it because of the stigma attached to it. In some parts of the world, it is like a millstone. They don't get help or support, and sometimes when help comes, it is too late. Here is an example of what happened in my country, Nigeria, on the 3rd May 2018. A lady lawyer butchered her husband with a kitchen knife and attempted to take her life after killing him. The woman's name is Mrs. Sidema Odibe, a lawyer and a native of Akwa Ibom. Her husband's name is Mr. Otike Odibe, a native of Delta State. The nature of the killing showed that the woman was accusing her husband of infidelity and external marital affairs. She cut his stomach open and also cut his penis and placed it on his right hand. She attempted taking her life, but was prevented from doing that by the neighbors. She was taken to the hospital, as you can see her on her hospital bed. According to their neighbor, who reported that the deceased called him to tell him of the threat to kill him from his wife. The man also called his mother and sister and reported his wife to them. But he was not taken serious. What a war. Now that the threat has been carried out, the man is dead and gone. The people that were supposed to come to his rescue failed him. They have lost a son, a father, a brother, an uncle, and a lawyer. The woman and her husband are both educated, though well educated. And now use this opportunity to call out to people to look for help when you are experiencing problems in your marriage. For the man, it takes a real man to understand that one woman is enough. Cheating can be frustrating.